गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर हियर स्टार्टिंग विद द चैप्टर एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम। यू नो ड्यूरिंग द वेरियस मेटाबॉलिज्म इन आवर बॉडी वेयर एक्सक्रीटरी मेनी एक्सक्रीटरी प्रोडक्ट्स आर फॉर्म लाइक अमोनिया, यूरिया, यूरिक एसिड अलॉन्ग विद दैट सोडियम आयन्स, पोटेशियम आयन्स, क्लोराइड आयन्स एंड मैनी अदर मेटाबॉलिक प्रोडक्ट्स विच आर टॉक्सिक टू अवर बॉडी आर नीड टू बी रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द बॉडी। आउट ऑफ दैम यूरिया, यूरिक एसिड एंड अमोनिया आर टॉक्सिक सब्सटांसेस एंड दे आर टू बी रिमूव्ड प्राइमरली। ओके, सो दैट फॉर दैट वी हैव एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम। अदरवाइज इन अवर बॉडी देयर आर मेनी वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स आर फॉर्म लाइक सॉलिड वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट, दोज आर बीन रिमूव्ड, अनडाइजेस्टेड वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट, those are been removed by the digestive system. Then gaseous waste product which is formed by the mechanism of respiration, cellular respiration, that carbon dioxide is removed by the lungs. Similarly, the liquid waste is removed by our excretory organ that is called as kidney. But in lower forms of life, the kidneys are not present. So in various animals, there are various excretory organs are present. Now here we are seeing that ammonia, urea and uric acid, these are the primary excretory product. So we'll see that ammonia is highly toxic and it is to be removed from the body immediately as soon as it is formed, and it is highly soluble also in water. It needs lots of water to get removed from. So ammonia can be removed in the form of ammonia itself in the aquatic animal, because in aquatic animal they are living in the enough amount of water, and in fact they want to get rid of water, so that ammonia is dissolved in water in their body and they can remove their excretory waste in the form of ammonia itself, so that they are called as aminotelic and their mode of nutrition is called as aminotelism. But in terrestrial animal, now I am giving you the example of aminotelic animal. Aminotelic animals are especially those animals which are living in water, and in this aquatic amphibians and aquatic insects and bony fishes are mainly included. Bony fishes, aquatic amphibians and aquatic insects are mainly included in aminotelic animal. In addition to that, many other animals are also there which are aminotelic. Now it comes ureotelic animals. So in terrestrial animals, the ammonia is converted into the less toxic form, that is urea. And urea needs less amount of water and it can be afforded by the animal for the considerable time, so that terrestrial animals can lose their excretory waste in the form of, they lose their excretory waste in the form of urea, and they are called as ureotelic animal. In that, especially mammals including man is ureotelic, and other ureotelic animals are these reptiles, some of the aquatic reptiles and some of the marine fishes and terrestrial amphibians. Terrestrial amphibians and examples are terrestrial amphibians, mammals and marine fishes, not terrestrial reptiles. These are terrestrial amphibians, again I am repeating, terrestrial amphibians, marine fishes and mammals. These three mainly comes under the category of ureotelic animal, but many other animals also can be included into ureotelic forms. And this process of removing urea as a excretory waste is called as ureotelism. Now, the third excretory waste is uric acid. Uric acid is least toxic excretory waste and it needs least amount of water. So that animal, those who are living in the scarcity of water, and like reptiles, birds and snails. Examples are very specific, so that we are to quote the example which are given in the NCERT book, so that I am taking them very specifically. However, various other animals are there, but we are to take the example from NCERT. Again, I am repeating, reptile, birds and land snails. These are ureotelic animal. Ureotelic means those who remove their excretory waste in the form of uric acid, and understand this phenomena of removing their excretory waste in the form of uric acid is called as uricotelism. So there are animals can be categorized on the basis of their excretory waste as aminotelic animal, ureotelic animals and uricotelic animals. With the example, with definition, we are to do this. Now here coming the next topic, that is excretory organs. So we are here mainly to discuss the excretory system of human being. But if we see the evolution of the excretory system, or you can say the process of excretion in various animal, so from the amoeba to the till the human, you can see that amoeba like organism, those are very simple, in that the simple process of diffusion takes place through the plasma membrane by which the excretory material can be removed from the body. Similarly, in porifera and cylindrata, the canal system is there. So outgoing water carries out the excretory waste of the body. Like in platyhelminthes class, the protonephridia or flame cells are the excretory organ of the class platyhelminthes. Then it comes the class Annelida. In Annelida, the excretory waste is removed by nephridia, who also helps in the ionic balance of the fluid in the body. Okay, and after the class Annelida, if we come to the chordates, then you can see in amphioxus also the protonephridias are present, or you can say the nephridias are present. I'll again can see that in amphioxus, yes, protonephridias are the excretory organs of the amphioxus, which is one of the protochordate. After that, the Malpighian tubules. In arthropods, the Malpighian tubules are the excretory organs of their body, and they also helps in the osmoregulation. Then antenal gland is one of the excretory organ of the prawns, or those also come under the category of arthropods. So that way there are various excretory organs are present in invertebrates, and then in mainly in higher chordates, the kidneys are the excretory organ. That we will be discussing in the next topic or next day. So here I have discussed you the various types of excretory waste and the types of removing the excretory waste. If ammonia is removed, then aminotelism. If urea is removed, then ureotelism. An eagle can be categorized on the basis of their excretory waste. And if uric acid is removed, then uricotelism and uricotelic animal, aminotelic animal, ureotelic animal and uricotelic animal. Similarly, the excretory organs of various animals also we have discussed. Thank you.